The disaster word itself was coined when, you know, there would be a server crash or where there would be some kind of an outage, and that used to be called as a disaster, and there used to be a mirror site, and, you know, so a network can be switched to another network. So disaster recovery, and in parallel we have emergence of enterprise level risk management, operations risk. So there are two or three such disciplines which now converge together, whether it is operations risk, whether it is enterprise level risk, whether it is information related risk, IT or infrastructure level risk. So all these risks have to be converging into what is integral part of any enterprise to be productive and answerable to the shareholders. I think that's what we call business continuity planning, or call it by any other word, disaster management. So I do not see that information security architecture can be very different or not aligned to any kind of business continuity planning. Earlier, you know, if you talk about information security architecture in particular, the ordinary threats were identified, for example, any kind of intrusion into the network. So we used to have intrusion detection systems, IDS, which were very popular. Some kind of firewall on the perimeter was put up. So we have come a long way. I mean, two decades from the 90s now, when IDS just came in and firewall was just happening. So today we are talking of, you know, we don't have to wait for intrusion detection. Companies would used to, you know, put up a security product and say, okay, I have put some security, I put some firewall, I'm secure. No, that is not the end of it. We need to understand that a breach can happen, and the, you know, the people out there are much more innovative, whether they come from Russia, China, wherever, they are much more innovative, they are much more technical savvy than the ordinary products that we can install. And our OEMs are actually learning from such of these, you know, people who are intruding into the systems. So today we have reconciled to the fact that a breach will happen. We need to also have someone in the business team who will identify a breach has happened and invoke the business continuity plan. And our architecture should be ready to not just look at a perimeter security, but also start looking at how secure are we once the breach has happened and the virus is already inside your systems and network. Our architecture has to be much more versatile, flexible, adaptable, and we need to do regular audits month on month. We should not, you know, do ad hoc months in a year when our consultants or whenever auditors will come, and on that a month before we start auditing. So we should have this as a live ongoing thing. Continuously look out for new security products, because the requirements for security are ever evolving. What was possibly secure a month or a 2 year back scenario is no longer secure today because new threats have emerged. So that is what we have to keep in mind. Cloud comes with a mixed feeling. There are some organizations which are very conservative, and they will think that cloud is insecure or less secure. So they think it is completely unsafe to go to the cloud, and they have a fortress mentality. So you can take very progressive companies like Hindustan Lever, Unilever, many others working in India. And I'm talking about my experience with British Telecom, many other clients that we face. They would take very baby steps towards cloud because their peers are already doing it, but they don't want to do it. So that's the fortress mentality that we witness and see around. At the same time, there are other companies who are very progressive. And I see that a lot in smaller enterprises who do not want to maintain IT as their core strength. They would rather focus on their product and marketing and manufacturing and outsource most bits of their IT. They definitely don't want to have any kind of a data center in-house. So they will outsource everything to something like AWS or Azure. Outsourcing something to a company like Amazon or a Microsoft, they think it's a very safe thing to do, and they will rest assured. But I think the world is very different out there. Neither should we be very secure or insecure. We have to do the cost-benefit analysis when we move to the cloud. Whatever is in need of the hour, and whatever processes, operations we can outsource to the cloud should be done, because at the end of the day, they are scalable, and we can save a lot of cost, particularly in this Corona times. Cloud, like I said, is a very interesting thing. At the same time, we need to integrate and have a common understanding. User training and all these things are very important. So whether we do cloud or whether we do not do cloud, if a user is unaware, he will misunderstand or misinterpret and take shortcuts, and all your security will go for a toss. For example, at BT, in the last month, month of April, in a single week in the country of Spain, we sold 40,000 VPN connections. that was unheard of. Nowhere have we sold 40,000 VPN connections in any single country in a single week. Why is this happening? Because of the small businesses wanting remote working. And when you allow your employees to do remote work, then you have to user train them. They have to understand what is VPN tunneling, how should they log in, where all they should not use public internet, they should use secure internet, and various other things that come along with it. Cloud, therefore, is a very interesting subject. That's all I can say. And at the same time, we should also have integrity or cohesiveness in different departments. For example, if you talk about the same breach coming in from an operations perspective, he will say, oh, there's a disaster. If you talk to an information security expert, he might think, oh, it is a denial of service. If you go to a IT guy, infrastructure guy, he may think, oh, it is some SLA we have missed. So these different interpretations will again, make the organization respond in a very different way. Now, a lot of organizations, we are promoting and moving them towards having some kind of platform, which is commonly known industry as GRC, in governance, risk, compliance platforms, and they can have many other names. But there is a team coming from different streams, different verticals, different buckets, and they together drive a business continuity plan or the cloud journey of an organization. Such misinterpretations will not happen and we will be secure.
For more updates from CXO TV, please like and subscribe to our channel.